What is net metering? First, let's take a little walk back in history and talk about what happened before net metering. I live in Vermont. Here in Vermont, one of the solar installers that I worked for actually installed the first grid-connected PV system in the state. This was in 1991. This is prior to net metering. So what our company had to do was actually develop a power production contract directly with the utility. There was a stack of papers about this thick to get that contract done. So what states realized is that we needed state-level legislation that allows people to hook solar electric systems up to the utility grid, and it also gives an idea of how they're going to be compensated. So net metering simply means that if I'm connected to the utility grid with a solar electric system, every kilowatt hour I send back to the utility grid will be compensated, I will be compensated at the same rate at which I am charged if I buy from the utility grid. So it's one-to-one. That is the definition of net metering. So every kilowatt hour I send back, I'm going to get paid at the same rate I'm charged if I buy a kilowatt hour from the utility. Now, let's talk about what's happening currently in the industry. A lot of utilities are pushing back against net metering. A lot of legislation is changing in different states that is not net metering. So for example, NEM 2.0, net electric metering in California 2.0, is not truly net metering because the amount that you're being compensated for every kilowatt hour that you send back to the utility grid is not at the same rate at which you are getting charged when you buy from the utility grid. And in almost all cases, that amount that you're getting compensated is less than the retail rate for electricity. So that puts a limit on the financial benefit of hooking to the utility grid. A lot of people ask, what's the biggest PV system I can net meter to the utility grid? A lot of that's going to depend on the utility that you're working with and the laws in the state that you're in. And many utilities will limit the PV system size to basically offset 100% of what your load is, and that's the amount of energy that you're using every year. Some will allow you to oversize a little bit. Others don't have any cap on the size of system, so you can get as large a system as you want. Some states have a cap, just a flat cap on, say, 15 kilowatt system is the largest system you can interconnect on a residential utility service. So really, it's going to depend on the rules and regulations in your area. Now, I mentioned already that net metering is changing in a lot of states, so it's really important to know what the rules are in your location and be active with your legislatures, your nonprofits in the area that are advocating for net metering, and also know how net metering is changing. So if you are in a location that does have net metering and they're thinking of changing it, it's probably a good idea to get on that program while you can, because you'll most likely be grandfathered into that program for an amount of time. And usually that's somewhere around 10 years. So you know at least for 10 years that you're going to have the benefit of that net metering. Another issue with net metering is it changes. So if you're not grandfathered into that net metering program, the financial calculations that you did when you got your system is going to change. A way around that is to include batteries with the system. Batteries give you some flexibility so that you can change how the batteries interact with the utility grid so that you can get the most financial benefit from the system that you can. Of course, that's not always going to be a financially viable option in many locations, but for some locations, it's a good way to be flexible and to be able to change how the system operates based on what the rules are in that location.